Try to feel the touch of air at your nostril. Take one deep, long breath, exhale deeply. Once again, take one deep long breath and while exhaling, slowly open your eyes. So, आम कुंभ इवाम्बस्थो जीर्यमाणा सदा घटाः योगानलेन संदेय घट शुद्धिम समाचरे। नाउ व्हेन यू प्रैक्टिस यू डेवलप ए काइंड ऑफ और यू एनर्जी विच इज वर्किंग इन यू, इट वर्क्स प्रॉपरली व्हेन यू स्टार्ट प्रैक्टिसिंग योगा। It becomes a kind of fire which eliminates all kinds of impurity from the system. That is what is yoganal. Sandeya ghat shuddhim samacharit. So this, all impurities not only at the physical level, it may be at the emotional level, it may be at the mental level. So all impurities are to be eliminated. That is what, that can be done only with the help of, as in Patanjali Yoga Sutra, if you go through the 28th Sutra of the second chapter, you will find Yoganga Anushthanat Ashuddhi Kshaye. When all impurities are eliminated, means impurities are eliminated on one hand and there is a light of wisdom. In that light of wisdom, you will be able to differentiate, I am not this, I am this. That is what is the purpose. So long impurities are there, whether you do asana, whether you pranayama, whether you do anything. So with the help of all these procedures, ultimately you are going to eliminate the impurities. And at one hand and on the other, you will develop a kind of wisdom, you know. And that in the light of that wisdom, you will be able to understand that I am this, I am not this. So the misidentification which we have developed with this body and the phenomena associated, so slowly, slowly it will be, a different kind of mindset will be prepared. That is what is the purpose. So how to do this, how to eliminate all these impurities, this is very, very important. So in the further verse it says, Shodhanam dridhata chaiva sthairyam dhairyam cha laghavam pratyaksham to niraliptam cha ghatasya sapta sadhanam. These are the seven methods. He talks about the seven methods. Shodhanam dridhata chaiva. Shodhanam, that is what is the purification. Dridhata, it is a kind of firmness. When you have decided something, you should be firm to that. You should not change your decision. So that is firmness. And sthairyam, steadiness. Now, dhairyam, it is patience. You may expect that I am practicing for the last 6 months, but not receiving or not getting the appropriate results. So you may be distracted from the path. Therefore, It says that somewhere or other, patiently you have to do whatever you are doing continuously for the long period of time. So patience is to be followed. And it is to be developed with the help of the practices. The practices are also mentioned henceforth. Laghavam, Laghavam, yesterday I was talking, you all are aware that Laghava here stands for Halkapan. Halkapan means lightness, lightness. Heavy, the opposite of this light is heavy. So, Tamogun is heavy in nature, Sattugun is light in weight, light, heavy in weight, Tamogun is heavy in weight, Guru Avarnakam. If you go through Sankhya Karika, wherein it is said, Sattvam Laghu Prakashkam. Sattva is said to be Laghu. Laghu means Halka. Halka means that is light in weight. Prakashkam illuminating. Upashtambakam Chalancharaja. Raja is said to be Upashtambakam stimulating, exciting, and shows the activities. Guru Avarnakam. Guru here does not mean master. Here means heaviness. Guru means Baripan. Heaviness. So Guru, heaviness and Avarnakam. It veils, it covers. That is Tamoguna. Anyanya Abhibhava Janan Methinchu. Anyanya Abhibhava. They are dominating each other and they are coming. So they are working like a revolving wheel. Here, how to practice this in our day-to-day life? This is the most important part. Friends, if you keep yourself under observation, sometime you are not in a mood. You are in a dull state, you know. You do not want to do anything. Sometime, in daytime, sometime you feel, oh, you are creative. You are light, you know, at the light mood. You are creative. Everything is present in you. That's that kind of thought. And on the other thought, you run after the objects for the worldly pleasures, for the sensory pleasures. So, in Bhagavad Puran, beautifully it is said, whenever Tamoguna dominates your personality, take the support of Rajoguna. Suppose you are in the class and you are feeling sleepy. So what you have to do? You should not fall asleep. What you have to do? You have to take the support of Rajoguna. Get up. Activity, some activity is to be done. Get up. Go to the tap. Wash your eyes. Instruct yourself. I have to be attentive in the class. And you will be attentive. It means you have dominated the Tamoguna with the help of Rajoguna. If Rajoguna increased to its limit, when you are more overactive, whenever you become overactive, immediately you have to take the support of Sattuguna. How to do this? How to? So recite Om, recite some mantra. You may think about some Vitaragi Purusha, automatically this overaction, overactive, this Rajoguna will be decreased to certain extent and you will be able to increase the Sattuguna. This is how in day-to-day life we have to work. This is what is yoga. On the basis of this, when you are in Vyasa Bhashya of Yoga Sutra, there are, chit is considered to be the ground where all playing is going on. All activities are going on. So, as a witness, because you are a witnessing principle. So therefore, the need is to witness your own activities. What is going on? That is what is sadhana. So, there are five bhumis. I think that Dr. Penna might have discussed this. So no need to discuss. But you have to witness this ground where all kinds of activity is going on. That is most important. Yes. Yes. No, no, because tamoguna and sattuguna both are static energies. You have to take the support of rajoguna. Because rajoguna is the dynamic energy. If you are a physical scientist, the electron, proton, and neutron, this is nothing but sattva, rajas, and tamas. So, tamas is a static energy, sattva is also a static energy, but these both energies are changing or working because of the rajoguna. So, when rajoguna accompanied with rajoguna, this is tamoguna, when accompanied with rajoguna, when accompanied with tamoguna, it leads you towards the worldly affairs. But when the rajoguna combined, accompanied with the sattuguna, it will lead you towards the other side. This is most important part, and in day-to-day life we have to work like this. We have to understand our own mood. Why this mood? Why this is happening? What is the reason behind? Something like that. Pardon? Electronic is rajas. Yes. Yes. Pardon? Hai bhumi, kshipta, mooda, vikshipta, ekagra, and niruddha. These are the five bhumis. It is described by Vyasa. Yes. That is also styan, that can also be tackled. Styan, vyadi styan. Styan is a heedlessness. How styan is to be understood? Heedlessness. You are unable to dive, or you are unable to heed into it because of the mental dullness. So this mental dullness can also be overcome with the help of sattva guna. Yeah, rajoguna is playing a role because it is not giving you chance to be heed into it. So at the moment, the rajoguna is dominating, not the, when mentally you are dull, it means that rajoguna is dominating. And so you have to take the support of sattva guna. When there is a physical alasyam, alasya is more. What is the difference then between the alasya and the styan? There's no difference. So styan is a mental dullness, and this alasya is a physical dullness. Yes. So you have to, what I do, let me, yesterday I was talking about that, about my master. When this kind of situation comes with me, I remember my master, okay? His activities, slowly, slowly, and that is the sattvic activities. So, or you may start some recitation of mantra, or I used to sing bhajan. Prabhu tum sakal jagat ke swami, ghat ghat ke nit antaryami. प्रभु तुम सकल जगत के स्वामी. आई कैन सिंग फॉर होल डे. डियर फ्रेंड, इफ यू इमीडिएटली दैट कामनेस एंड कम काम एंड यू विल बिकम काम एंड कंपोज्ड. इफ यू देन ऑटोमेटिकली दैट you will be able to heed into it thereafter. So you have to take the support. Very correct, because it is an obstacle. Vyadi, styan, sanshay, pramad, alasya, avirati. Avirati, bhiranti darshan, anavasthitattva. These are the nine obstacles in the path of yoga. So styan is considered to be the mental dullness. You are very correct, that way. Okay. So pratyaksham, here pratyaksham does not mean indriya sannikarshat utpannam jnanam pratyaksham iti. It does not mean pratyaksham. Means it is a kind of realization, it's a kind of actualization. Though the word pratyaksh is used here, but when we say pratyaksh, if pratyaksh can help us, then why Patanjali putting this in under the vritti? So yogaj pratyaksh and the pratyaksh which is based on your sensory organs, they are entirely two different. So pratyaksham here means the actualization actually. So this pratyaksham actualization and nirliptam, liptam, when you are totally engrossed with the worldly affairs, it is called liptam. And when you are nirliptam, so the lotus is nirliptam. Okay, so that is the state, and this state can be, nirliptata comes only when you reach to the highest state, that is called the liberation or the kevalya, whatever you call it. So these are the sapta, ghatasya sapta sadhana, these are the seven methods by which you will be able to become nirlipta. Sorry, someone is talking. Because I will be distracted. So no thought. So sorry. Shat karmana shodhanam. Now, how you are going to do this? Shat karmana shodhanam. All the seven this mentioned in this verse, shodhanam. How you are going to purify the system? Purify all the impurities will be eliminated only through the shat karmana. Shat karmana shodhanam. Asanen bhaved dridam. Dridam, firmness. That is what. Or you may say, you may get this strength because of the asana. And mudraya sthirta, the energy which is dissipated can be made steady, you know, with the help of mudra. Let us understand the meaning of the term mudra. Mudam, mudam means anandam. Mudam, mudam, anandam, rati, lati, iti mudra. That is what. Because I am a man of Sanskrit, I can speak in Sanskrit also. If you speak with me, then only. No need to. Okay. 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 Mudam anandam, bliss. That which gives you bliss is called mudra. That brings the bliss to you. That is called mudra. Mudam anandam, rati, lati, iti mudra. That is mudra. So it gives you that kind of sthirta, steadiness. Means your energy which is dissipated, which is not working properly, it becomes steady. Then, pratyaharena dhirata. Dhirata is a patience. Dhairya is a patience. Pratyaharena. Yesterday we were talking about the natural. थोड़ा पानी का इंतजाम करना पड़ेगा. यह है, सॉरी. धीरता मीन्स पेशेंस दैट कैन बी डेवलप. सी आवर सेंसरी ऑर्गन्स, दे आर रनिंग टूवर्ड्स देयर रिस्पेक्टिव ऑब्जेक्ट्स एंड द पर्पस ऑफ प्रत्याहार इज टू विड्रॉ द सेंसेस. इन अदर वर्ड्स, it can be done very patiently because janm janmantar ka ye swabhav bana hai in indriyon ka vishayon ki taraf jane ka. So it takes long time, so therefore you should be patient with regard in respect to the withdrawal of the senses from the their respective objects. Sthirta, happiness, steadiness. You in mudra protects your energy and therefore it gives you a kind of steadiness. Yeah. प्राणायाम यामात लाघवम, लाघवम हल्कापन, प्राणायामम प्राणायाम प्राणायाम हाउ दिस प्राणायाम कैन गिव यू दिस लाइटनेस। पतंजलि इन इज योग सूत्र ततः व्हेन यू बाह्याभ्यंतर विषय अक्षेपी चतुर्थ तथा क्षीयते प्रकाशावरणम। यस्टरडे आई वॉज टॉकिंग अबाउट द कवरिंग फ्रॉम द कॉन्शियसनेस विल बी रिमूव्ड एंड व्हेन द कवरिंग इज रिमूव्ड धारणा सुच योग्यता मनसा दाउ यूर यू गेट एन एबिलिटी टू फोकस यूर माइंड एट वन प्लेस दैट इज वॉट इज द रिजल्ट। वेन यू आर लाइट इन वेट वेन यू आर हैप्पी एट दैट पॉइंट ऑफ टाइम वेयर एवर यू फोकस यूर फोकस विल बी प्रॉपर। सो द लाघवम कम्स ओनली बिकॉज प्राणायाम इज कंसिडर्ड टू बी द बेस्ट तप अकॉर्डिंग टू मनु। एंड वट इज दैट इफ यू ट्राई टू अंडरस्टैंड द कंसेप्ट ऑफ तपस, तपो द्वंद्व सहनम, दैट इज वट व्यासा सेज इन हिज कमेंट्री। वट इज दैट तपो द्वंद्व सहनम? यू हैव टू वेयर द कॉन्फ्लिक्ट्स। What is the dvandva? Dvandva is the opposite, pairs of opposite, har jeet, hani labh. You know har jeet, hani labh, these are the dvandvas. Bhukh pyaas at the physical level, bhukh pyaas, hunger and thirst, regard and disregard. This is a mental dvandva, regard and disregard. Now, victory or loss. हानि लाभ, हार जीत, मान अपमान, रिगार्ड डिसरिगार्ड, सुख दुख को एक समान समझ, क्या हानि लाभ क्या हार जीत, अर्जुन उठ गांडी बूठा, फिर देख धर्म की होगी जीत। दैट इज व्हाट इन द भगवद गीता। दीज आर ऑल द पेयर्स, पेयर्स ऑफ अपोजिट। Yes, pardon. Yes. Sir, as I said that our sensory organs, they naturally goes towards their respective objects. Because in Kathopanishad it is made clear, sensory, pranchi khani vyatranat, it is meant outside. So, yesterday or day before yesterday, I was talking with you, or yesterday, not day before, only yesterday only. So, Patanjali says in his Yoga Sutra, if you recite Om, contemplate upon the meaning of this Om, then what will be the result? The result is that your chetana, which is flowing outward, it will become introvert. Pratyak chetana adhigama. 29th sutra of the first chapter. Chetana becomes introvert. So, with the help of these procedures, if you are performing asana, and if you are concentrating on the body parts where you are getting the stretch. So at that point of time you have withdrawn from the other aspects, you know. So if you are working with as a kind of worship, you know, if your work become like a worship, it means you are withdrawn from all other sides, isn't it? When you think about whether I will be successful in this whatever I am doing, whether I will be successful or not, then your energy will be dissipated. Don't you think so? So then you will not be able to withdraw totally. So you will be able to withdraw only when your work becomes worship for you. So when you are reciting Om or Jap, doing Jap, this Mantra Japa or anything, Pranayama, when you are totally devoted to this, suppose you are practicing pranayama, so inhalation and exhalation, you are totally merged with this. So this totally merging, you are at that point of time, at least you are withdrawn from all other sides, isn't it? Say for example, concentration. In the childhood, you know, when we were in the school, we were using this, we were sitting outside in the sunlight, you know. In Himachal Pradesh, there is too cold. So we were sitting in the daytime, we were sitting in the sunlight for our study. And we were using a glass, you know. What do you call it? No. Lens. Magnifying glass. So the जो पढ़ाकू लड़का होता था उसके उस पर लगा देते थे, फिर वो ऐसा ऐसा करता था तो हमको बहुत मजा आता था. There is a river. Just day before yesterday I saw this temple, you know, Shivaji temple, and this river is full of water. बिकॉज जब नीला पानी होता है तो पानी बहुत गहरा है. सो देयर आर टू साइड्स ऑफ द रिवर. देयर इज अ वॉल, यू नो, इजंट इट? देयर इज अ वॉल, एंड बिकॉज ऑफ दिस टू वॉल्स द वाटर इज हैविंग द करंट. इफ यू एबॉलिश द वॉल, देन वाटर विल बी स्कैटर्ड. It will lose its current, isn't it? And you will be able to walk on the water because you are not disturbed now. But when you have made these two walls, so water is coming with current. If you go inside the water, automatically water will take you towards the downside, isn't it? That is what is the concentration. That is what is kind of worship whenever you do anything. That kind of concentration, that kind. So automatically this withdrawal comes automatically when you understand, when your mindset is your inclination towards the other side. I was long back, 10 years back, I got an opportunity to become a director in Shimla in this, but I said that no, I will not go there. I am happy with this because my mindset is that was a political post, you know, and therefore I said, even though Morarji Desai, Dr. S.K. Sharma requested me, you come and become director in Morarji Desai. I said no, I am not interested. Why? I have withdrawn myself. Why? Because I know the consequences. My path is different and this path is different. So I do not want to go there. So my withdrawal, this is a kind of, it is a mindset, you know. And this mindset can be made only by recitation of mantras, by doing the various procedures given in the yogic literature. So this will help you to withdraw. Yesterday I was two words, prang mukha and pratyak chetna. Prang chetna and pratyak chetna. So long we are extrovert. We cannot escape. You will not be able to withdraw. You can withdraw only when you are pratyak chetna, when you re-channelize, redirect this flow towards the other side, then only you will be able to, otherwise not. So there are everything, whatever you do, whether you are cooking, you know, it is said in villages, raag rasoi pagadi kabhi kabhi ban jat. Raag means raag. Abhi now, yes, it is a gapa gare sare dasa ga gare gapa da. गा गा रे गा पा दा सा दा सा दा पा गा रे गा पा गा रे सा रे दा सा गा गा रे गा पा दा सा 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 रे गा रे सा रे दा सा गा रे सा दा पा सा सा दा पा गा रे सा रे गा पा गा रे सा रे दा सा गा. दिस इज द टाइम फॉर भोपाली राग. So this is a Bhopali. So अब ये इसमें घुस जाएंगे तो so this withdrawal comes only when you have a clarity of mind, and this clarity of mind comes only when you eliminate all kinds of kachra, impurity, you know, then only you will be able to become pratyaksha chetana. Otherwise it is very difficult. Yes, you are developing discrimination because of this Viveka Khyati. Patanjali uses the term Viveka Khyati. But you don't say discrimination, because when you say only discrimination, then I am discriminating you from her, because you are a Videshi and she is Desi. So discrimination word is also used for this. So don't discriminative discernment. When you say discernment, it is a Italian word, discernment. So when you add this discriminative discernment, it becomes Viveka Khyati. Otherwise, if you check only discrimination, then I am discriminating you because you are Videshi, foreigner, and she is Desi, Indian. You understand? Yes, sir. Actually, this only by chanting this Om, that is what is the Om Sadhana. Yes, but you have to, that is what Patanjali says, tad japaha tadartha bhavanam. This is what is the procedure. If we follow this procedure properly, then only our chetana becomes introvert. So that is what is the upasana. That is what is the Om upasana. It's the Om. This transcendental meditation, it is nothing. It is a mantra japa in the beginning. And while doing mantra japa, slowly, slowly, when you do japa, so you reach to the state of mental japa. And when you reach to the state of mental japa, you become, thereafter become objectless. That is what is transcendental meditation. The name is transcendental. You are going beyond your this bodily and mental limitations. That is transcendental. Ji? Niralambana, without any support. That is what is transcendental. No, in the beginning it is not. It is loudly you have to do it. Then when you go on doing, so you exhausted and only your lips they whispering. And thereafter, okay, so we'll have to. Because we have to complete the 2 chapters at least. It is mentioned in the program. Okay. So pranayamena lag dhyanat pratyaksham atmana, that is actualization. Pratyaksham I was talking. When we say pratyaksham, prati or aksha, prati is the opposite. But if we go through the Nyayika's definition of pratyaksha, then they say indriya sannikarshat utpannam jnanam pratyakshamiti. Whatever the knowledge you are getting through the sensory organs, with the help of the sensory organs, means the mediators are the sensory organs, that knowledge is called pratyaksha. And always this pratyaksha is, the anuman is always based on the pratyaksha, means inference. Say for example, if you are at the side of this nadi, this river, and you see the muddy water is flowing in the river, so immediately you infer that though there is no rain, but it may be raining at the hills, and therefore there is a muddy water in the river. This is an inferential knowledge, isn't it? So inference is always based on our pratyaksha. So, therefore, Patanjali is very scientific in his presentation when he talks about the, he doesn't define the pramana here. Pramana, he doesn't define. प्रमा करणम प्रमाणम, दैट इज व्हाट प्रमा मीन्स, यथार्थ अनुभव इज सेड टू बी प्रमा, मीन्स द वैलिड नॉलेज इज सेड टू बी प्रमा, एंड करण इज द इंस्ट्रूमेंट, द इंस्ट्रूमेंट थ्रू विच यू आर गेटिंग द वैलिड नॉलेज इज सेड टू बी प्रमाण अकॉर्डिंग टू पतंजलि. बट पतंजलि डज नॉट डिफाइन दिस. इफ यू ट्राई टू अंडरस्टैंड दिस प्रमाण, यू कैन अंडरस्टैंड विद द हेल्प ऑफ विपर्य. हाउ ही डिफाइन्स दिस विपर्य, ही सेज मिथ्या ज्ञानम, विपर्ययो मिथ्या ज्ञानम अतद्रूप प्रतिष्ठम. अतद्रूप, नॉट तद्रूप. तद्रूप मीन्स यू आर अनेबल टू सी द ऑब्जेक्ट एज इट इज. बट हियर, सो वट कुड बी द प्रमाण, यथार्थ अनुभवम, मीन्स वेन यू आर एबल टू सी द ऑब्जेक्ट एज इट इज, दिस इज कॉल्ड प्रमाण. एंड वेन यू आर अनेबल टू सी द ऑब्जेक्ट एज इट इज विपर्य, रॉन्ग नॉलेज. नाउ हियर, इफ दिस इज ए यथार्थ ज्ञान, इफ इट इज ए वैलिड नॉलेज, भाई पतंजलि कीप्स दिस अंडर द वृत्तिज, एंड ही सेज वृत्तिज आर टू बी रेस्ट्रेंड समवे और अदर. इट मीन्स द नॉलेज विच वी आर गेटिंग थ्रू द सेंसरी ऑर्गन्स, विद द हेल्प ऑफ सेंसरी ऑर्गन, दिस नॉलेज कैन नॉट बी वैलिड नॉलेज. देयरफॉर ही हैज यूज्ड द वर्ड, दो इट इज द सेम टर्मिनोलॉजी, बट हियर व्हेन घेरंडा सेज ध्यानात प्रत्यक्ष आत्मात्मना, थ्रू द ध्यान यू आर एक्चुअलाइजिंग द सेल्फ थ्रू दिस ध्यान, दैट इज प्रत्यक्ष इज, इट इज ए काइंड ऑफ एक्चुअलाइजेशन, नॉट दैट इंद्रिय सन्निकर्षात उत्पन्नम ज्ञानम. इज इट ओके? नाउ समाधि ना निर्लिप्तम मुक्ति रेव न संचय, दिस नो डाउट. निर्लिप्तम यू बिकम लाइक ए लोटस यूनिदिरा विदाउट एनी अटैचमेंट, सो दैट इज व्हाट इज द निर्लिप्तम, एंड दैट निर्लिप्तम इज नथिंग बट इट इज ए वेरली लिबरेशन, नथिंग एल्स. नाउ कमिंग टू द वन बाय वन, सो can you just, it will be in front of you, or you would like to see this one? No, I have just made a chart, I was just making this chart. She suggested me that you go and sleep now today, but I couldn't sleep, and I was involved in making a chart for you, this of Shuddhi Kriyas, and I wish that this chart should be with you. Okay, I was working on my laptop and I have prepared only, it is just the name you will get. कहाँ गए वो मित्र हमारे, वो जो डील करते हैं, आप भी करेंगे ना? नहीं नहीं, आप सॉफ्ट कॉपी ले लीजिए, प्रिंट ले लीजिए, मेरे पास प्रिंटर नहीं है. वन वन दिस धोती, दिस इज वन, दिस इज वन चट क्रिया धोती, देन गो एड प्लीज. आगरा नेक्स्ट वाला चाहिए ना, जस्ट वो उसको आगे कर दीजिए. हाँ, देयर इज ए बस्ती दो, नेती तीन, लौलिका, लौलिकी बोले तो नौली, इन अदर वर्ड इट इज नौली, एंड त्राटका इज फिफ्थ, एंड सिक्स इज कपाल भाती. नाउ वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट द धोती, गो बैक, विल कम बैक लेटर ऑन. सो दिस धोती, दिस इज द ओनली बुक which elaborates this chat kriya like this, no other book is elaborating like this. So it is a wonderful manual given by Gheranda. And here antar dhoti means we have to purify the internal part, internal. Dant dhoti, though it is a dant, means dant stands for the teeth, but it is a your frontal this part, you know, it is to be cleaned with the help of this. Then Hrid Dhoti, it is the heart region. That heart nahi, jiske tukde hajar huye, koi idhar gira, koi udhar gira. Wo wala nahi. Please try to understand. So the Hriday, and this Mool Shodhan is the lower part, wherein the rectum as well as everything, you know, everything comes below the umbilicus area, you will be able to clean it with the help of this mool shodhan. So this antardhoti is of four kinds according to, and this kind of description is not available anywhere in the scripture. So therefore I thought it is better to make a chart and give it to you so that you can have the chart and you can think over it. This bathsar and this three things you have to use for the sake of cleaning the system, you know, three things. And what is that? You need air, water and clothes in all the aspects. Water, air and clothes, nothing else. So vatsar, vat stands for the air. So vatsar, air you have to use. Bari, bari stand for water. So water. Bannisar, it is agnisar kriya. Today morning I was talking about agnisar kriya. So you have to 100 times shatvaram we are going to discuss. Just take this bannisar and then vahishkrit. Vahishkrit rectal cleaning hai ye. Vahishkrit rectal cleaning, nothing else. Then comes to the dant dhoti. Dant dhoti is also of four kind. Dant dhoti, teeth, every day we are brushing, you know. Then jibba moola, it is to be cleaned properly. Then karan dhoti, ears, we are using the words sometime, you know. Are we using the words or not? Yes. And kapal randra. Kapal randra is the frontal sinuses. That is to be cleaned. Then hrid dhoti, this is what is danda. Danda, nowadays there is a rubber tube, you know. We insert the rubber tube inside and take danda dhoti, you know, danda dhoti. Water we are drinking and taking like an elephant, you know, taking with the help of this danda. No, kunjal is a different. Kunjal is different. But you are putting the tube inside. I can do it in front. I can demonstrate, you know, if you want. But I have not brought that tube with me, you know. That is the problem. So, Baman Dhoti, that is what is the Kunjal Kriya. Baman Dhoti, that is Kunjal. And this Vastra Dhoti, Vastra Dhoti. I would like to share with you people that I was suffering from asthma and it was acquired. In medical science, there are only three kinds of diseases, you know. When people talk about this yoga therapy, so I was scared, you know. So this, let us understand little bit about this. Because ultimately, you are making this ghata without any disease, you know, with the help of all this. And the value of these shatkriyas, there will be actually no disease if you practice it properly. In medical science, there are only three kinds of problems in medical science. Any one of you having this background of medical science? Koi Ayurveda ka ya kisi ka? So first one is, the problem comes from the mother's womb. Say for example, hole in the heart. Hole hota hai bachcho ke? Have you heard this? Yeah. Or there's a problem related to the ball, you know, in the heart. The child comes out and he is suffering from this problem. Can yoga do something to this? No, cannot do something. Yoga can do after operation, some rehabilitation programs can be organized for such people, nothing else. Now the second one is, the hereditary problems. Bansha, kya bolenge usko? Banshanugam se aayi hui. Banshanugat, hereditary problems. Now, for the hereditary problems, if you follow a proper yogic way of life, then you will be able to postpone the problems. Say for example, if the parents are suffering or great grandparents, they are suffering from diabetes or asthma or whatever the psychosomatic or other problems, cancer, heart attack, high BP, this and that. So if you follow the proper way of life, you will be able to postpone these problems, you know, to a certain extent. So preventive. Then there are acquired problems. Acquired means because of your wrong habits, you have developed some problems. So acquired can be an infective diseases also. But sometime you have developed some, you have acquired some problem because of your wrong habits. So here are these problems. The acquired problems can be rooted out with the help of yogic methods. Now the second one is, this hereditary problems can be postponed. Say for example, up to 60 years, if you are following the proper way of life, whatever your parents are having the problem, this problem will be postponed. You will not be a victim of the same problem. But if it gets manifested, suppose in your 50s, the problem of diabetes, because of the hereditary, the diabetes manifested. If you follow the proper way of life, you will be able to maintain that diabetes. That is what can be done. Nothing else. So this is what is the basic we have to understand with regard to. And therapy is not the purpose of yoga, to be very, very frank. If you go through the therapy book written by Swami Kubilananda, in the beginning he has written, therapy is not the purpose of yoga. If you have a higher goal, if you are working for the higher goal, this is the byproduct. Automatically your gut will be purified, your mind will be purified, your emotions will be settled, everything will be. So this is a byproduct. This therapy is byproduct. If you follow the proper way of life, it is a. So I was suffering from asthma. Although at this moment my mother is suffering from this asthma, at this moment I was not knowing. But when I came to Lonavala, because of this climate, you know, so I developed this asthma. Then Dr. Karmelkar, who was the senior most member in Kevaladham, I discussed with him. I used to call him Kaka. Kaka, I am suffering from this, and sometime unless oxygen is put, you know, I may die. This is the problem. He suggested me, why don't you go for this Vastra Dhoti? Let me tell you, in the beginning it was a bit difficult to swallow this Vastra, you know, but when, because I am very fond of milk, you know, in the childhood I was very fond of milk. So I poured the Vastra in the milk, and then I started swallowing it. And I swallowed the dhoti, you know, in 3-4 days I could swallow the dhoti. And I was practicing this alternate day. And I am sitting in front of you now. Every day I am taking this buttermilk here, you know, and there is no problem. For the last 15 years, there is no problem related to asthma because of this Vastra Dhoti and a proper way of life. So, means this was acquired problem, and I could overcome this with the help of the yogic procedures. So, acquired problem, suppose there is a diabetes, if it is acquired, it can be rooted out. Believe me. Because such type of people are there, those who have acquired because of their wrong habits. So this can be overcome. But if it is a hereditary, it cannot be rooted out, but you will be able to maintain it. So all this, what you call the cleansing processes, Shat Kriyas are. Now what is the difference between Panch Karma and Shat Kriyas? Panch Karma of Ayurveda and Shat Karma of Hatha Yoga. What is the difference? Because this Panch Karma is prescribed only for the sake of treatment. Here you are not performing this for the treatment. Nowadays we are using these Kriyas for the treatment.
But it is not treatment. You have to keep the ghat clean, you know. That is what is the purpose behind. Do I agree with this statement or not? Yeah, colon part, yes. So we'll go one by one. Let us understand antar dhoti, what is the bak sar dhoti. So one by one. Now are you interested to go for, you are having the books? Yes, sir. Ji. Actually, no, it is when you drink water up to the glottis and when you develop that ability to throw the water out. Nowadays, how our students, they are doing, you know, this, they are putting the two fingers in the glottis and then they take out the water. That is not proper. Vastra, when you eat the vastra, it takes all the mucus which is attached to the your this esophagus. Yeah. Yes. But there is a difference. With the help of this water also, it is also helpful. But Vastar Dhoti is more effective than चटके हुए उसको भी साथ में लेके आता है वो घसीटते हुए लेके आता है वो इसके लिए बट ज्यादा देर नहीं रखना चाहिए उसको बिकॉज वाइल डूइंग दिस एक्सपेरिमेंट यू नो सो वस्त्र धोती वो चली गई और रोज कैंची लेके जाना पड़ता था उसको कैंची लेके काटना पड़ता था रोज एवरी डे बमन धोती वस्त्र धोती इज मोर इफेक्टिव मच मोर इफेक्टिव एक्चुअली एक्चुअली दोनों में फर्क है आप अगर ट्यूब लेकर के करते हैं तो वहां कोई बात पानी इधर उधर जब आसपास में नहीं वहीं से पकड़ करके पानी ट्यूब से ऊपर आ रहा है तो आपने बीच का रास्ता जो है ना उसका वो जो पानी कुंजल करते हुए जो पानी आपके सब वॉल को छू करके आता है वो ज्यादा मोर इफेक्टिव होगा यानी दंड धोती से ज्यादा इफेक्टिव बमन होगा बमन से ज्यादा इफेक्टिव वस्त्र धोती होगी ऐसा आप पकड़िए वो जस्ट एक इंक्लिनेशन टुवर्ड्स दैट कि आप बाहर फेंकने की क्षमता आप में आ जाए वो दैट इज व्हाट इज द प्रॉपर बट ऐसा समझिए आप दिस दंड धोती the Baman is more effective than Dand Dhoti and this Vastra Dhoti is more effective than Baman, than Kunjal. That can be. No, well, Neti karte, but when I started, we were doing this Sutra Neti, not the rubber. Nowadays, the rubber catheter is available, so we put the catheter nowadays. But when we were doing with the this sutra neti, so this works more, you know. The rubber mein aur isme difference hai na thoda sa. So it works. So it neti is a ENT specialist. Neti kriya is ENT. There's no need to go to the ENT when you are practicing neti continuously. Aankh ka bhi problem aur kaan ka bhi problem aur Marathi mein bolte hain ghasa. हाँ जी एक चार उंगल उसका चौड़ाई होती है और 32 फीट लंबी होती है हाँ बट इफ यू स्टे लॉन्ग विद दिस धोती इट गोज डाउन नो इमीडिएटली यू हैव टू टेक यू हैव टू ईट देन यू हैव टू रोटेट द स्टमक ओके लिटिल बिट लाइक नौली क्रिया And then you have to take it out. So all mucus will come along with this vastra. हाँ पकड़ के तो रखना पड़ती है Come time, sometime you see. Yes, you come and see. Yes. पार्डन नो नो व्हेन यू आर सफरिंग फ्रॉम अल्सर इट शुड नॉट बी प्रैक्टिस्ड देयर आर प्रिकॉशंस दे आर टू बी टेकन बमन इज ऑल्सो नॉट अलॉट टू द पर्सन हु इज सफरिंग फ्रॉम द दिस अल्सर so even though this danda dhoti all are they are not like person like you person like should not do no that in the morning I was talking about mataji subha she was talking with me in the practical class after the practical class that mataji you know हाँ स्वामी नंदिनानंदा जी सो आई सजेस्टेड हर टू प्रैक्टिस द थोरेसिक ब्रीदिंग नॉट द एब्डोमिनल ब्रीदिंग बिकॉज शी वॉज प्रैक्टिसिंग एब्डोमिनल ब्रीदिंग एंड देयरफॉर एक्चुअली बिकॉज ऑफ द एज एंड बिकॉज ऑफ हर स्पाइनल दिस ऑपरेशन यू नो हर लंग्स आर श्रिंक्ड टू सर्टेन एक्सटेंट So if she so just in the morning and thereafter she met me in the in at the lunch time and she said I practiced thoracic breathing and I felt it is good for me that's what she was talking about so sometime therapeutical value of these chatkriyas it is marvelous there's no doubt about it but thing is we have to keep in mind no you should not do this
yaad aa gaya do kar lete ko baal baat itne mein jab tak aap se baat
karte okay dhotir basti tatha neti laulki is nothing but it is yes sir pardon That is when you no here I आगे ले जाना अगला वाला here is the neti water and thread both it is mentioned here the basti is also jal basti and shushk basti which sthal basti two types of basti that we'll discuss in detail and lalaki is balm it is only one kriya madhyama nauli when you take the rectum towards the left side it is balm nauli when you take to the dakshin side it is have you seen this ramdev baba ji is yeah and tratak is also one but it is vahi rang as well as the antarang antardishti vahir laksha antar laksha vahir drishti people don't understand whether Your eyes are opened, but your laksha is different. Antar laksha. That is what is the Trataka. And Trataka plays a very, very important. And this one, piche, aapka. So we can we continue because it is 5:15. Can we continue? Okay. So dhotir basti tatha neti laulaki tratakam tatha kapalvati chetani shatkarmani prachakshate samacharet. That is what. अंतर धौती दंत धौती हृद धौती मूल शोधनम धौती चतुर्विधा कृत्वा घटम कुर्वन्ति निर्मलम व्हाट इज द पर्पस घटम कुर्वन्ति निर्मलम घटम दिस बीमारी दिस ऑल घट दिस सिस्टम एंड व्हेन वी से लेट मी टेल यू फ्रेंड्स माइंड एंड बॉडी दे आर नॉट डिफरेंट सो बोथ शुड बी निर्मल अदरवाइज कबीर सेज नहाए धोए क्या करे जब मन का मैल न धोए व्हाट इज द यूज ऑफ टेकिंग बाथ यू आर वेस्टिंग द वाटर नथिंग एल्स इफ यू आर नॉट प्यूरिफाइंग यूर इनर व्हाट यू कॉल अंतर मन नहीं साफ किया तो देन व्हाट इज द यूज दैट इज व्हाट इट सेज सो घटम कुर्वंती निर्मलम मीन्स बॉडी माइंड कॉम्प्लेक्स विल बी प्यूरिफाइड विद द हेल्प ऑफ दिस सो बासारम बारिसारम बन्नीसारम बहिष्कृत घटस्य निर्मलार्थाय या अंतर धोती चतुर्विधा दिस अंतर धोती इज ऑफ फोर काइंड नाउ ही विल डिस्क्राइब और दी बातसार धोती। हाउ टू डू दिस बातसार धोती। काक चंचू लाइक ए बिग ऑफ ए क्रो। काक मीन्स क्रो एंड चंचू मीन्स द बिग ऑफ ए क्रो। आसियन पिवेद वायु शने शने। आसियन आसी स्टैंड फॉर द माउथ। यू हैव टू इनहेल। कैन यू डू इट? दिस इज ऑल्सो कैन यू एनी वन ऑफ यू शीतली प्राणायाम करता है क्या कोई आप में से? शीतली प्राणायाम? यस। नो यस यस। क्या आप ऐसा मुड़ करके, लेकिन उनके जे गोदी में, जिनकी गोदी में ही है, इट नॉट इजी टू डू। जिसकी जिब्बा लंबी होगी वही कर सकता है, ये छोटी जिब्बा वाले नहीं कर सकते। नो शनि शनि लेटस। काक चंचू वद आसियेन। नाउ एज या वट एवर ही वॉज डूइंग इन द बिगिनिंग दैट कैन ऑल्सो बी, बट इफ यू डू लाइक दिस यू हैव टू इनहेल। काक चंचू नाउ इट इज ए काक चंचुवत। नाउ आसियन पिवेद थ्रू द माउथ यू हैव टू सक द एयर इन साइड स्लोली दैट इज वट चालेद उदरम। देर आफ्टर यू हैव टू रोटेट द उदरम, द एबडोमिन शुड बी रोटेटेड एंड देन पश्चात बर्तना रेचियत शनि। देर आफ्टर यू हैव टू एक्सेल व्हाट यू कॉल थ्रू द लोअर पैसेज नॉट द अपर पैसेज। लोअर पैसेज यू हैव टू एक्सेल। बर्तमना मीन्स द लोअर पैसेज। यू हैव टू थ्रो दिस सो विद द हेल्प ऑफ वट एवर। सी यू कैन टेक वन एग्जाम्पल। सपोज इन द पाइप देर इज ए कचरा, यू नो इन द पाइप। सो हवा आप जोर से मारते हैं तो देर कचरा निकल जाता है। दिस इज वट इज द प्रोसीजर। वो काक चंचू की तरह भरना है उसको और धक्का दे करके उसको नीचे ले जाना है, और जाते 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 जब तक होता नहीं उसको निकालना है। ये बात सार की बात है, ये है टेक्निक उसकी, ये धक्का देने वाली बात है। वेन सपोज देर इज ए इन दी वो जहां एंटीसेप्टिक में और इसमें उसमें वो क्या बोलते हैं उसको नहीं ये जो अपन ये जो पाइप में से जो कचरा जाता है, हाँ जी नो एनीमा वो अलग चीज है, वो पानी से रिलेटेड है। बट अनीमा लगा करना ये इसके गैलन के अनुसार अनीमा के जैसा है, लेकिन वो सक करना है वो गुद प्रदेश से। इट इज यू हैव टू सक द वाटर इनसाइड, दैट इज ए सेपरेट, दैट विल कम एंड वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस दैट। बट हियर बात साइज यू हैव टू इनहेल थ्रू द माउथ एंड यू हैव टू व्हाट इज द पर्पस ऑफ डूइंग दिस, दैट इज व्हाट आई वांटेड टू डिस्कस विद यू। द पर्पस इज दैट वट एवर इज स्टिक इनसाइड विद द हेल्प ऑफ दिस एयर इट विल कम आउट, दैट इज वट इज द पर्पस। जैसे पाइप में कचरा होता है और उसको हम फोर्स से हवा से या पानी से उसको निकालते हैं, वो वह पर्पस, दैट इज वट इज द पर्पस। हाँ जी फ्लश आउट करना, दैट इज वट इज द पर्पस। एंड यू माइट हैव सीन दैट इन मेडिकल साइंस समटाइम दे आर फ्लशिंग आउट, यू नो सम दे आर यूजिंग दिस काइंड ऑफ इंस्ट्रूमेंट्स, दे आर फ्लशिंग आउट द दिस व्हाट यू कॉल द पैसेजेस। सो दैट इज वट इज द पर्पस इज टू फ्लश आउट, दैट इज वट इज द पर्पस। सो यू हैव टेकन दिस फ्रॉम द माउथ बट इट इज टू शुड बी टेकन फ्रॉम द लोअर डोर। सो दैट इज वट नो शीतली इज डिफरेंट। आई एम नॉट टॉक यस दैट इज ओनली अप टू इज ओनली फॉर दिस शीतली प्राणायाम. इट इज अ थोरेसिक. इट गोज अप टू नॉट इन द एब्डोमेन. यू हैव टू क्लीन द एलिमेंट्री कनाल. यू हैव टू क्लीन. दैट इज व्हाट इज द पर्पस फॉर डूइंग दिस बासार धोती. द एलिमेंट्री कनाल इज टू बी क्लीन्ड. दैट इज व्हाट फ्लश आउट. दैट इज व्हाट इज द पर्पस. Yeah, it is that. You can only through the mouth also. If you are unable to twist the tongue, yeah, you can do it with the mouth also. There's no problem. Okay. Then, Bhasaram Param Gopyam. It is said that it is a secret practice. Param Gopyam, the highest secret. Deha Nirmal Karakam. It cleans the body. सर्व रोग क्षय करम. इट रिमूव्स ऑल काइंड्स ऑफ प्रॉब्लम्स. देहा निर्विवर्धकम. इट इंक्रीजेस द गैस्ट्रिक फायर ऑल्सो. दैट इज व्हाट इज द पर्पस. नाउ द अदर वन इज आकंठ. आकंठम पूरियेद वारी. नाउ हियर ऑल्दो द वर्ड आकंठम मीन्स टू वर्ड अप टू द कंठ. आकंठ इन संस्कृत जैसे आश्रम. आ समंतात. सिमिलरली हियर आ इज ए प्रीफिक्स यूज्ड फॉर समंतात चारों तरफ के लिए. सो हियर आकंठम अप टू द ग्लोटिस. दैट इज व्हाट इज द मीनिंग ऑफ आकंठ. बट हियर यू शुड नॉट डू दैट बिकॉज इफ यू फील द यू आर ड्रिंकिंग वाटर फॉर द कुंजल अप टू आकंठ. बट हियर द मीनिंग ऑफ द कंठ विल बी डिफरेंट. सो डोंट टेक इट एज पूरियेद बारी. यू हैव टू ड्रिंक द वाटर. भक्तरेण च विवेचने. यू हैव टू ड्रिंक द वाटर थ्रू द माउथ. चालियेद उदरेण एव चो उदराद रीचियेद अधः. देन दिस वाटर इज टू बी टेकन फ्रॉम. द पर्पज इज टू क्लीन द एलिमेंट्री कनाल. दैट इज वट इज द पर्पज. सो बात सार विद द हेल्प ऑफ एयर यू आर क्लीनिंग द एलिमेंट्री कनाल. यू मे क्लीन इट विद द बारी विद द जल विद द वाटर why drinking it same. And then it says actually kuch log karte hain. Nahi baatsar nahi karte hain lekin pani wala karte hain. In other words kaise karte hain. Nowadays you are doing this क्या कहते हैं उसको. नो शंख प्रक्षालन बोलते हैं. दिस इज नथिंग बट इट इज ए बारिसार इज नथिंग बट इट इज ए शंख प्रक्षालन इन अदर पर्स. सो दैट वी आर डूइंग. आई एम ऑल्सो डूइंग दिस. साल में एक बार मैं भी करता हूं. सो इट इज इन अदर वर्ड्स इट इज ए शंख प्रक्षालन बिकॉज यूर एंटेस्टाइन इज लाइक ए कॉन्च यू नो. सो एज वी आर वॉशिंग द कॉन्च यू नो similarly we have to do it. And there are five asanas. You know this? No? Tadasan, Tirigh Tadasan, phir aapka Kati Chakrasan, and then thereafter you may perform this Bhujangasan, Kati Bhujangasan, and last one means sirf aapne usko system ko pet ko hi twisting karne wale asana. ये पांच ही आसन है सर. देर आर ओनली फाइव आसनाज विद हेल्प. यू हैव टू ड्रिंक द वाटर बट इफ यू पुट लिटिल सॉल्ट इन इट दैट विल बी टू गुड. नॉट टू मच सॉल्ट बिकॉज व्हेन यू मिक्स द सॉल्ट इन द वाटर सो यूर दिस इंटेस्टाइन विल नॉट ऑब्जर्व द वाटर. सो देयरफॉर इट इज ईजी फॉर यू टू गो. Drink water, do asana, go to the toilet. Drink water, do asana, go to the toilet. And water should come as it is, you know. That is what we are practicing here in Kavaledham. This bath, I don't see the people who are working bathsar, but barisar is being done. Barisar means, in other words, it is a sankh prakshalan. Yes. So that barisar is nothing, it is a sankh prakshalan, in other words. Then Bannisar, Agnisar, today morning I was talking about. So he is talking, Barisaram Param Gopyam. Again he says, Barisaram Param Gopyam is the same. देह निर्मल कारकम अगेन इट प्यूरिफाइज द सिस्टम साध्य तन प्रयत्न एफर्टफुली यू हैव टू डू इट देव देहम प्रपद्यते योर बॉडी बिकम लाइक ए डिवाइन यू नो डिवाइन बॉडी ए डिवाइन टेम्पल फॉर द सेक ऑफ हरि हु इज सिटिंग इनसाइड इन दिस टेम्पल नाभि ग्रंथि मेरु पृष्ठे शत बारम च कार्यत दैट इज व्हाट टॉकिंग अबाउट नाभि ग्रंथि मेरु पृष्ठे यू हैव टू टेक दिस शत बारम 100 टाइम उदरम उदेर्य आमयम त्यक्त्वा ऑल काइंड्स ऑफ प्रॉब्लम्स विल बी जठराग्नि विवर्धयत एंड योर गैस्ट्रिक फाइल विल बी इंक्रीज नो यू हैव हाउ टू डू दिस यू नो दिस नो अग्निसार कैन यू शो लिटिल बिट इफ इट इज फुल डोंट डू इट टुमारो मॉर्निंग यू शुड शो ओके जस्ट यू हैव टू एक्सहेल यू हैव टू एक्सहेल एंड देन यू हैव टू यस अदरवाइज आई कैन डू इट नहीं करा दो ना क्या होता है कुछ नहीं होता दिखा दीजिए अच्छा रहेगा लोगों को समझ में आएगा भला होगा हाँ टेक्निक जरा थोड़ी जबरदस्त है धीरे धीरे आ जाता है फिर कंट्रोल आ जाता है निकालने के बाद आपको हियर इट इज मेंशन शत बारम 100 टाइम बट वी शुड नॉट गो बियॉन्ड अवर लिमिटेशंस इफ यू आर एबल टू डू इट फॉर 5 टाइम्स इन द बिगिनिंग यू विल नॉट बी एबल टू डू इट 5 टाइम्स ऑल्सो बट टू टॉक ऑफ ही इज टॉकिंग अबाउट द शत बारम so it when you become habitual then only you will be able to do it for a long period but we should not go beyond the limitations then only you have to do after in udyanbandh you are taking the posterior stretching is there here you have to pull you take and relax release pull and release And with the help of this, you know, so many problems, there will be no. Navli cannot be practiced without this Udyan and Agnisar. You will not be able to perform this Navli. Haji? Dikhayenge na subah. Kal bahut mauka. Chalo 5:30. Pardon? Last. Should I complete this Bahishkrit Dhoti at least? Okay. So, Banni Saram Midam Dhoti Yoginam Yogi Siddhida, it will give you the perfection. Esha Dhoti Paragopya Na Prakashya Kadachana. It should not be shown to anybody if the person is not legit. Because you should show it only for the person who is interested. Otherwise, the person can laugh at you. That is what it says. Anything, whatever is. Kaki mudra sadhitva puriyed udram marut dhariyed ardh yamam tu chaliyed adhvartmana. Kaki mudra, again this kakchanchu, kaki mudra. Having formed the kaki mudra, One should fill the stomach with air, retain it for 1.5 hours, ardha yamam, 1.5 hours, and force it down along the lower passage. So, chaliyad vartmana, again you have to take it from the lower door. That is what nabhi jad. So, this will be discussed later. This is what is what you call the chaliyad. Kaki mudra sadhitva puriyad udram marut. धारियत अर्ध जामम इट इज 1.5 आवर्स यस चालिएत उदरम, देयर आफ्टर यू हैव टू रोटेट द उदर, चालिएत अर्धवर्तमना। काकी मुद्रा इज मोस्ट इंपॉर्टेंट हियर। बड़ा मुश्किल है, इट इज बिट डिफिकल्ट, बट जितना देर हो सके, मतलब डेढ़ घंटा के बाद ही वो जाता होगा नीचे, तभी तभी तो, ऐसा थोड़ी ना, बट इट इज नॉट इजी, बट प्रैक्टिस मेक्स मैन परफेक्ट। मैं तो नहीं कर सकता हूं, आप कर लेंगे तो पता नहीं। ओके, सो नाउ इट इज टॉकिंग नाउ ऑफ दिस नाभि मग्न जले स्थित्वा शक्ति नाड़ीं विसर्जयेत् कराभ्यां क्षालयेत् नाड़ीं यावद् मन्द विसर्जनम्। नाउ वी हैव टू, नाभि मग्न जले, यू हैव टू गो टू द वाटर अप टू दिस लेवल, नाभि लेवल फॉर बस्ती। सो बस्ती कैन बी डिस्कस टुमारो। सो बहिष्कृत धोती में ये काकी मुद्रा साधित्वा पूरियेत् उदरम्, काकी मुद्रा से ही उदर को भरना है, यानी एब्डोमिनल ब्रीदिंग, दिस इज एब्डोमिनल ब्रीदिंग वी हैव टू डू, एंड देन 1.5 hours वी हैव टू कीप, वी हैव टू रोटेट, एंड देन इट शुड बी टेकन फ्रॉम द लोअर डोर, एंड दैट इज व्हाट इज कॉल्ड बहिष्कृत। सो विल दिस रेस्ट विल बी डिस्कस्ड टुमारो मॉर्निंग।